Hey, what up, guys? It's Dave from a YouTube video, Junior Dave Blah. Today, we're gonna be talking about my Yashica D camera, and this tutorial or video is to show you guys the ins and outs about it and how to go about using it. If you guys just pick this up, or if you guys are interested in buying one, I'll be going through all the little things that you need to know about it. All right, so let's get started.
Alright, so a little knowledge about the Yashica D. It takes 120 film. It does not have a light meter, so be sure to take something that takes light readings. Right here I'm showing you the case, and you just pop it out from the back and from the bottom. It just takes little clips, little buttons that you snap off buttons. I prefer to leave it like this, but if you do want to take it out of the case completely, you do so by pulling these pins up here. And then you just pry it out. Just be careful with your knobs. You don't really want to mess them up too much. And here's the case by itself. Notice that the straps on the side are removable. And here's a closer look of the buttons. So you could use the same strap and put it through this loop and force it in the slit. And you pull up to secure and you do the same on the other side. Alright, now let's talk about the front. Alright, so this is for your shutter speed, and this knob is for your aperture, for opening and closing. And here's a better look of it. Anything lower than 30th of a second, you're going to want to put on a tripod. Here I'm going to put it in bulb. And I'm just going to mess with my f-stop. So again, you're going to want to put this on a tripod if it's lower than 30th of a second. Here I'm going to show you guys how to work the self timer. Okay, this is your focus knob. You want to get your subject in focus first. This right here is your self timer, which you're going to cock a little later. You're going to want this little lever from M to X. Cock the self timer, cock the shutter, and then hit your shutter release. Alright, this is your PC port. You're going to need a PC cord. This is PC to PC. Those are the names of the terminals. And put it here. And I happen to have a Nikon Speedlight SB800. And it has a PC port as well. So this works fine for me. Just going to turn it on here. And screw this in. And now we're ready to go. I'm gonna cock the shutter, put the self timer. You don't need to have it on, but I'm just doing it just for demonstration to show you that this camera is triggering the flash. And here we go. Voila. Okay, now I'm gonna talk about the shutter release. There usually is a ring screwed on here. I took mine off so I can put my shutter release cord. This cable is a Nikon AR2 cable release, and it's an F980 series. But any of the 900 series can use, just make sure you can screw it on. So it firmly goes on like this. Now if you do want to use long exposures, you're going to need to have your cable be able to lock down. And to lock this cable down, all I need to do is release this little thing here, and it locks down. So if I want to do a long exposure for, let's say, 30 seconds, or I'm doing some nighttime photography and I need something around a minute or less or more, And just to show you, alright, so on this side, this actually holds your flash, it does not trigger flash, and these are the pins that are going to be holding your film inside. So on this side, you have your viewing window for you can see what shot you're on. This is to advance the film. This is to the button to release so that you could advance your film, and this is your knob for focusing. This does not zoom, this is plainly for focusing. Alright, now let's move on to the viewing window. So here, I'm showing you that I am unfocusing and focusing the photo. And this is what you would see on top. Let's get it nice and clear now. Alright, so to get some fine tuning, there is a magnifying glass on top. And that's what you use to do your fine tuning. There's also a small viewing window that you could drop down the front panel. All you do is push down this front panel and it locks down. And this little window in the back is if in case you're shooting sports and you don't want to look down and you want to follow your subject. You don't hold this up close to your face. You want to keep it at arm's length. To bring back this front panel, all you do is hit this little lever, this little switch here, and it pops right up. Again, let me show you from the front side. And since this is a twin reflex lens, only the bottom lens is what's actually going to be hitting your film. What you're viewing is from the top lens. Alright, so now let's get to the loading and unloading of film. So what you do is you're going to want to unscrew this. It has little labels to tell you which way to open and close. You want to do this in the light sensitive area. You don't want your negatives to get film, to get light leaks or anything like that. So we prop this open. And since I finished shooting my roll of film, I have film in there already. And to take it out, we just pull this top pin here. Like so. You'll notice that your film will pop up and then you just pull it. Now keep tension on your film. You don't want it to unwind. This roll of film just happens to have adhesive. I have seen other ones where you lick like a stamp and it sticks on together. But for this film, it has adhesive, just like a little sticker. And then you just flip this over onto the film. I do like to have a fold just so when I am in the dark room, it's easier to take off the sticker. Now continue putting pressure on the film so it doesn't unravel itself. And now you're good to go. You just store that somewhere until you're ready to develop it. All right. So now you're going to want to put this cartridge back up to the top side. And you're going to pull this pin. And you want to move it up. Now it is a little tricky. So here's some points. You're going to want to align these little notches right in there. Make sure that the little pin does move all the way down, just as so. Alright, notice these little red triangles. This is where you're going to advance your film to. So we want to put our film down here, come up, and then put it in the little slit of the cartridge. Right here. We want to point this up so it's easier on us. Alright, this is the type of film I'm using. The 400 stands for the ISO. You're more than welcome to use whatever ISO you want to use. This This is just a film that I have for this demonstration. And again, you're going to want to do this in a low light area. So be sure to pinch your film so again it doesn't unravel, and you want to do this all the way through the process. Put the right side in first, pull the pin, make sure the pin comes all the way in. Keep tension on your film. Now we want to keep the folded part of the film into the slit and start winding. On many rolls, there's different type of indicators to tell you where you're going to want to wind up to. Mine just happened to be arrows. Yours could be different. You want to line those up to the red triangles. Like so. All right, now we want to close this up. And screw this close. And you're good to go. Alright, so in your viewing window, you're going to see an S for start. We're going to wind this up until you see a 1. When your film stops advancing, it's going to click into place and you're going to be able to see 1. You're not going to be able to move this. You're ready to shoot now. So now I'm going to focus on your subject. I'm going to cock my shutter, focus, and then I'm ready to take a photo. Now to take my second shot, I'm going to need to push this release and turn, and then I'm ready to go for my second shot. And when you see 2 and it clicks into place, you're ready to do this all over again. All right, we're coming up on our 12th shot. And now we see a little red circle with a red dot. That means my film is done. You're going to keep winding this up. It's not going to stop anymore, but you want to keep winding it up till you hear paper rattle inside. That means you rolled up your whole film, like we saw earlier. Alright, so tips for cleaning the lens. First, you're going to make sure you don't have any film. And this is the part I want to clean. But to see the dust better, I'm going to want to put this on bulb to keep the lens open. And I'm going to hold down the shutter release. And now I can see all the dirt and dust that's in there. And you can clean this with a variety of different things. All right, these are just a few of the photos that I've taken with this camera. I did process the negatives and I did process the paper. So I did process all of these on my own. For this shot, I did use the timer and the flash. Well, guys, thanks for watching. I hope you liked it. Give it a thumbs up if you enjoyed it.